takes 10 years. Is it true? There are places it takes 20 years. They have never seen rain. Amen. Tulikaa mpaka tukawa tukaona kama Mungu ametuondokea Kenya. I said, Mungu alikuwa na to teach some other things that we are supposed to do. Amen. Turn with me in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 8. Naongea juu ya the battles of life as a topic ambayo tunaitanga the enemies you need to conquer to possess the land. Somebody say it, amen. The enemies you need to conquer. The enemies you need to yourself. Judges chapter 3 verse 1. Before I go to the other one, the Bible says, and these are the nations. Listen to this. Judges chapter number Judges chapter number 3. I just want to read and I run to Deuteronomy chapter number 8. Judges chapter 3. I'm still there. These are the nations that the Lord left in the land to test. Tell your neighbor to test. Mwambie mwenzako to test. God does not tempt man, but God tests a man. I repeat my statement again. God does not tempt a man, but God tests a man. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, and God tested Abraham, a level of love. That was the battle that Abraham was to win around his life. God tested Abraham. He tested him. So these are the nations that the Lord left in the land to test those Israelites who had no experience of the war of Canaan. We value every areas of life becomes a battle and becomes a war that you need to understand daily as man goes. He says, he did this to teach the warfare to the generation of Israel who had no experience. Number two, you need an experience to manage some issues of life. You need an experience to understand and ask somebody about some certain business. Before you indulge yourself in any single business, you must first of all ask the people who have been in the same business. Jeremiah 6:16. The Bible says, when you are at the highway, when you are at the crossroad, when you are on the big road, the Bible says, stand and ask. Don't move. Stand and ask of the old ways. In other words, the people who have gone through the same road, they can easily advise you about what will happen. Are we together? It says, they had no experience. These are the nations. One, the Philistines. Those living under the five Philistine rulers. The Philistines, the Amorites, the Canaanites, the Jebusites, and all those. And I am still speaking about the characters of the same nations. Because every nation had a character. That is number one. Simple. Like every community in Kenya. Every community in Kenya. Before you settle in their land, number one, you must first of all learn their character. Learn their character. Learn their gods. Learn their places of worship. Learn their before you establish a business in a certain area, even in Kenya. If I come to your place, if the time I come there, number one, lazima nichue tabia. Tabia. Tabia za watu pale kwenye unakwenda. Hawezi kwenda katika watu huzijue character zao. You abuse them. Number two, you must understand and identify their place of worship. Place of what? That if their place of worship does not connect with your God, that is number one, the idolatry in that land that you need to fight first of all so that you can establish an altar in the same place that can give you the authority and the control of the same land. That's why Abraham, chapter number 12, in Genesis, verse 6 and 7, the Bible says, and Abraham traveled in the land of Canaan. He traveled through. The first thing that he did when he arrived at the land, the first thing that Abraham did was to raise an altar. Why?
When you raise an altar in a particular place, you kick out any other altar, any other god of the same area, that you take the dominance of the god that you are worshiping. That's why God was saying, consciously, the people that I've left them there, number one, after you arrive there, you are the one to drive them out of the land by worship. You can have a praise, you can have a prayer, and you can have a sacrifice that can overpower the people of the same land, and you become a dominant. Amen. Now, these nations that I've been talking about, that God left to the children of Israel, hile mataifa aliacha, niyo mataifa ni simplicity, nikamwambia kwamba kila nation ilikuwa na character yake. I did read these characters to all of you. I told you, number one, the Hittites, this means their terror, one what you call fear. Fear is a demon. Fear is a satanic spirit that comes, they call it fear, means a false evidence that appears real. When the devil wants to scare you, he scares you with fear. Because fear, you yourself, Jeremiah, you are the one to fight fear. Any agenda, any project, any business you want to go into, number one, you must conquer fear. If you conquer fear, then the faith rises, you can do all things. You can do all things. You read, they say, if you read the Bible, there are over 365 times mentioned the word fear. Don't fear, don't fear, don't fear. 365. In other words, every day you wake up in the morning, you stand and say, because it is you, who yourself, because you believe in the Lord, the fear can never be in you. You cannot fear because you know you are with God. Daniel said, the people who know their God, number one, they stand strong. They stand what? Despite the challenge, despite the opposition, despite what you are looking at, because there's a difference between looking and seeing. What you are looking at, it is not what you are seeing. Am I right? Jeremiah chapter number 1 verse 11, the Bible says, and God asked Jeremiah, what do you see? Not what are you looking? Because what you are looking can discourage you, but what you are seeing can encourage you, that you can pursue what you are seeing than what you are looking at. I want you to take note of those words. Take note of those words. What you are seeing, what you are seeing. God told Abraham, stand, my brother, stand, Abraham, when Lot had chosen the other side of the place to stay. And the Bible says, God said to Abraham, stand and see the far you can see, I have given you. The far you can see, I've given you. Now, what you are looking at, it can be very scary. But what you are seeing, it is beyond. When the children of Israel, that is the 10 spies, the 12 spies, went to the land of Canaan to spy of the land, the Bible says when they went there, they can Anakims, the son of Anakims. Every family in Israel, they were given the nation to conquer. Even Caleb was given the Anakim. Why? Because Caleb, these are the first people he saw. And they say to God, I am ready to take over this land. These guys I am seeing, the Anakims, who had 6 fingers. The guys were tall. They were huge. They were powerful. But Caleb says, give me these characters. These are bread. And for sure, the same one God gave them. What you don't fear, God gives to you, and you conquer it. I say you conquer what you don't fear. Amen. If you are seeing a greatest business and you are not fear, you are seeing it, you are not looking at it. When you look at it, it discourages. When you see it, encourages. Joseph said to his father, I have seen. Not I have looked, I have seen. There is a difference between seeing and looking. Looking is for the body. Seeing is for the soul. That's the subject for another day. That's why I'm doing that book. When you understand a true man in 3 segments, the soul man, the body man, and the spirit man. What the soul see, but the body looks at. That's why the soul can depart from a man when you are asleep. It can travel to Nairobi. It can travel to America. It can board the aeroplane while the body is right there. What you are seeing, What are you seeing? Because what you are seeing and you're not fearing, it gives you the confidence to take it. Caleb said, give me these idiots. Give me this mountain. Give me this Anakim. And for sure, when they entered the land, he was given the same nations, the same people, the Anakims. He entered there. Caleb defeated them and they won against them. There are seven nations in Israel who never defeated the nations which were occupying their inheritance. So everybody that is here, there's somebody that is occupying your inheritance. You need to fight those nations which are scaring you from your inheritance. Na urithi wake ilikuwa ni juu yako pigane paka upokee. Bwana asiwe sana. Urithi wako kila mtu anapewa yake. Kama ni biashara ya kuuza mandasi, that is your kingdom. Kama ni biashara ya kuuza mahindi, that is your kingdom. Kama ni biashara ama kazi, that's a kingdom. It is you to fight until you overcome what you are seeing there. Praise the Lord. It is no issue. So the Hittites, they stood for terror. Means terror. Fear. They are scary. And the fear is the greatest enemy for any believer. The Bible says, and God talked to Joshua and said, Joshua, listen to me, that my servant Moses is now dead. Fear not. Stand and be strong and march forward. In other words, you are not looking at what everybody is looking at. You are seeing what somebody is looking at. Kuna tofauti ya kuona na kuangalia. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Kuangalia, unaangalia hapa na unashushika. Unaangalia, unatishwa. Unaangalia, lakini ukiona. Caleb alisema, hawa wana kimu ambao unawaona ni warefu na wazito. Walio na vidole sita. Hawa ni chakula. These are bread. Anasema we can go and fight them and take over the land. And for sure, the day of the distribution of their inheritance, the Bible says, and Caleb was given the same nation. The Bible says he defeated them and they took over control and left his children by the inheritance. Let me tell you what your father feared. God will give you the courage that you're not going to fear. You must fight it until you take control. I say you fight it until you take control. I don't care who is standing against you. But today, that nation of fear is coming out of you in Jesus' name. Siku moja unajijasa, unakuja unamwambia, nataka kukuoa. Kama maneno hakuna mingi, sema nataka kukuoa, I am a man, na niko na ng'ombe 25. Na hata kama hakuna yuyo, unajijasa. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Every nation, that it was representative of a certain character. I said, what? Certain character. Can you imagine those people were given the Girishites? These guys were unstable. Girishite means unstable. Unstable, but you are fearing what is unstable. You don't know what you are doing. Fear. Nobody will take fear out of you, Dennis. It is you who take fear out of yourself. Hakuna mwenye atakuondolea uoga isipokuwa wewe mwenyewe. Mungu hawezi kukupatia jukumu ashindwe kukusaidia kwenda nayo. Bwana asiwe sana. Mungu hawezi kukupatia kitu ambaye anajua uwezo. Na nimekuambia, God does not tempt men. God tests men. And whatever God tests you, because it's going through your examination so that you can give you a pass. And whatever that you see, because you believe in it. Believe what? The 12 tribes kila mtu aliambiwa kwamba every family, kila familia chukua mtu moja, kila jamii, kila kabila. Chukua moja. Baada kuchukua moja, kila mtu muende, muspai inchi na mchague mahali mnataka. Let me tell you, wacha Mungu atupatie that opportunity today. Mimi nitachagua Nairobi City. Nitaweka fence yangu Kiambu na nieke thika, wengine watafute huko Machakos. I wish God can return, can roll back again and say, let, even during the independence time, there are people are complaining today that they are poor. But that time independence, when it came to Kenya, everybody was given an opportunity. Go and fetch, because already freedom is here. And I declare from this altar, already there's a freedom from above. Go and take your possession without fear.
Without fear. Kuna watu leo hivi waliogopaga kule leki, kule George Lakeview. Naitwa Lakeview. Ah. Na George. Pale kanza Moses iko na George. Leskosh. Kuna watu waliogopa tumbili huko. Waliogopa. Waliogopa wakasema huko chini tumbili zinanyang'anya watu mkate, sijui zinaingia kwa nyumba. But they are courageous men. Walienda wakafench. Leo ni pesa ngapi my brother? Race course. How much money is race course, Shamba? Kaproti 10, 50 by 100. How much is it? It is not less than 10 million. 10 million, 5 million, all those are. Kuna watu waliogopa. One day Jack was telling us here, ati wakati walilelewa hapa Nakuru, sijui nini inaitwa freehold, kulikuwa ni tumbili wanatembea na zebra, sijui huko nini, ule mzee wa Zakayo, sija Zakayo, haya huu mwingine wa, anaitwa Jengera, wakakuja wao wakafence. Wakafanya nini? Wakafence. Leo inanunulika. Inanunulika. Hata hapa reli, hii tupa hapa reli hapa. Tulikuwa hapa brother, tulikija hapa 2010. Muzomali akakuja akaangalia na yume shinda hapa tall years. Akaangalia akaweka fence na akaenda. Wakati leo hivi tunaangalia petroli, you admire, you say God, I wish. Those are regrets. Regrets come because of fear. And I declare, nobody shall fear. God shall take those enemies out of you. He will give you grace that you come out of it.
Brother, I regret today. Leo. Wanaishi historia. Unajua, sisi ndio tulikuwa wa kwanza hapo Nakuru town. Unaona pale guest house. Ndio tulikuwa tunakutana wazee, tunakula busa. Nikaona ni kupaya mzungu anaonekana, tukatoroka tukaenda huko subukia huko juu ndio watu waone.
Watu kareji as kama wakina stem, watu wakina kuste my friend, walikuja wakafence hii town, ilikuwa inaonekana kama kichaka. Wakafence several land of acres hapa mjini. Bwana siwe wakafence wote. Wakafence.
Fear is an enemy that you need to fight yourself. You fight what?
Yourself. Mungu aweze kukupatia inchi, akikupatia inchi. Bwana Biblia inasema walipofika hapo wakaanza kunungunika na wakalalamika. Wakamwambia Joshua, Moses. Walipofika hapo kila familia iliambiwa basi sasa kila mtu kujeni mtoe report yenu. Caleb akasema ile mlima hii, mnaona hii mlima hii ya Hebron hii. Hapa hii mlima hii. Hii ni yangu na watoto wangu. Hii ni yangu na nini? Na alipokuja akawakuta hao hana kimu wako hapo. Akamwambia brother, I was here 40 years ago. Nilikuwa kijana. Saa hii I'm 85 years. Nimeenda another 45 years. But the energy I had 40 years is the same energy I have today. That's why I want to tell you the confidence you had the first time is the same confidence. What makes me preach here every day, the confidence that I had the first day I came here is the same confidence I have today, is the same confidence I have tomorrow that the greatest cathedral shall be built in the city of Nakuru. I don't care how many can speak against me. How many?
I don't care. No, I don't care. My friend, brother, we see tulikuwa na hapa. Tukakuja hapa. People look at us and say, you are very few. How can you do? Today, we are celebrated people that we are on land in the CBD. Wachana wale wote. Watu wameenda sijui kwa mshamba ya mnyama. Inaweza mshamba wa mnyama. You run out from the city. Nani atoroka town? Mimi nilizaliwa town. In fact, as a matter of fact, mimi penye nimetoka kwetu kule nimezaliwa ni town katikati. Mimi nilianza kuona magari nikiwa mtoto mdogo, nakaa kwa tingatinga sikilima kwa barabara na watch tunahesabu magari hivi.
Tulihesabu magari na my brothers mpaka wakakufa na wakuendesha, mimi niko na gari leo. Sema no fear. Sema hakuna uoga. Hakuna mtu atakuondolea uoga. Hakuna mtu atakutongozea Steve, si kweli? kuna wapo msichana saa zote atimtana watajiri na nini kumbe hata yeye anakunoki anakutaka na wewe unajifanya tu mtaki. Jitolee ndio mwambie sister nakutaka wewe ukue bibi yangu vile unakaa ati hiyo class yangu mwambie atakufanya class tutaingiana hapo hapo tukiingia kwa inji hiyo nyingine tutarekebisha. Kuenda kutongoza huyu bibi yangu ilisuguliwa na wadada saa zote nafanya mazoezi ya kwenda kutongoza ikifika hapo na melt nafika hapo na sweat. Siku hiyo nikaenda fasting ya 3 days dry, no water, no nothing. Nikaambia Jehovah, give me courage like a lion. Any lady on my way I will tell her I will marry. Honestly speaking, that was August. I will never forget the day I told her I want to marry you. It was August. Nilitoka hapa na kuru brother nimejijasa nimefunga 3 days nimejifungia sinyo hata mata jimezi. Nikasema wasichana wameruka hivyo na wamenikataa kataa safari hii zimekataa kukataliwa. Ndio naona watu wanaona kama roho zisa ni chief. I'm a very very confident. Mimi unajua kuna mtu hapo mara. Hata huru nikimtafuta nikimhitaji. I've not needed sinyemja muhitaji maana sina kitu serious kumwambia. Nikimuitacha ufind him naenda namwambia niaje man vipi kuna maneno hapa nayataka lakini sijakuwa na vitu serious because sijatafuta hata gavana. Till I need the friend I'll go there. Why, what is a human being like me? All I do is in a man of authority. I'm also a man of authority. I am a man of authority as the same as a man of authority. Both of us we are in authority. He is in authority in the land of Kenya, but in the spiritual realm, Christ King Celebration Ministry International, I am the man in church. Who says so? Kila mtu ni mkubwa kwake, ama ni aje? Kwani kuna mtu akona watoto 20 alafu anaitoka libaba na mwingine anaitoka kababa? Everybody is called baba. Ukiwa na mtoto mmoja na mwingine akona 26, unasema eh wewe lile libaba ni aje? Eh wewe kababa. Kuna mtu anasema hivi? All of them you are what? Bana ziwe saa. Nikajijaza nikaenda maombi, nikaenda hacho, kwenda tuombe. Nikamwambia hakuna kuomba. Hiyo nimeomba imetosha. Hiyo nyingine utaomba baadaye tukishaoana. So she prayed today. Mimi na relax ama ni hapo. Unaogopa kitu what you fear will never happen. Kile unaogopa sana kitatendeka. Unanielewa hivi? 100% of what you are fearing that it will happen, it will not happen. And what you cannot even do, what you are trying to, because the Hittites, they are called, it is described as terror. These are the nations that were left to teach you war. To teach you what?
War.
When Adam was permanently is on war, kuna biashara deni unafanya hapo nje. Siku nazo unauza soda hapa next na wewe. Ukiletewa hapa biashara, si lazima na wewe ufanye bidii uuze. Unakaa hivi. Mtu akwambia sina soda, nataka hiyo soda yako si baridi, naambia kaa hapa, give me 1 minute, let me brew. So what? Si ni kweli? Ni vita. Ukimwacha hapa si ataenda kwa jirani. Na next time mwacha arudi. Am I talking to somebody? Hai. Ndio ni back courage. Mwambie mwenzako courage. Mwambie mwenzako courage. Please talk to somebody, tell him courage. Please talk to him, say courage. Another spirit of the Hittites is confusion. Because the devil number one brings what you call confusion. The descriptions of the Hittites who were in the land, he stands for confusion. The enemy enjoys confusion. Enjoys what?
Confusion. Confusion. Wadada wanakuja kama waini. Unashindwa mwenye unaambia. Ulikuwa umeanza na huyu? On your original plan. Sema confusion. You know confusion is a spirit? You know confusion is a spirit? I said, do you know confusion is a spirit? Confusion is a spirit.